Do you like your job, Professor McLuhan?
America was able to develop and apply swiftly all the consequences of printing. In the book, the newspaper, and by extension the assembly line in industry and organization and markets, because there was no backlog of obsolete technology to be liquidated first. Europeans had to struggle through a long, painful period in order to clear enough room to exploit the new print technology.
Quanto è bella la prospettiva.
Okay, now once more with more expression, Irving.
Quanto è bella la prospettiva.
Now hold it. That's part of the script.
Our Renaissance legacy was the vanishing point, the single static viewpoint of the limited optical science of the time. This single piercing view demanded a central point of interest and an undisturbed, restful symmetry to either side of it.
This is the place to see it from, Phyllis.
Good.
The eye, it cannot choose but see. We cannot bid the ear be still. Our bodies feel where'er they be, against or with our will.
Those who write the anatomy of the experience...
The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of culture.
The divisions in here...
The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of culture. The alphabet is an aggressive and militant absorber and transformer of cultures.
I've never been here before.
Now for the evidence, said the king, and then the sentence. Now, said the queen, first the sentence and then the evidence. Nonsense, cried Alice so loudly that everybody jumped. The idea of having the sentence first.
The alphabet is a construct of fragmented bits and parts which have no semantic meaning in themselves. Must be strung together in a line, bead-like, and in a prescribed order. Its use fostered and encouraged the habit of perceiving all environment in visual and spatial terms, particularly in terms of a space and of a time that are uniform, continuous, and connected. The line, that good old reliable continuum, became the organizing principle of life.
Advanced systems of so-called typesetting really get going, then I think that it would be very, very simple to, and inexpensive, and quite reasonable to simply record conversations.
Yeah. With all we habitually say, I don't follow you.
They're chopping and groping. Yeah.
The new principle, how does that grab you, is a more involved, multi-sensuous approach to the problem of meaning.
As we begin, so shall we go.
Rationality and logic came to depend on the presentation of connected and sequential facts or concepts. For many people, rationality still has the connotation of uniformity and connectedness. I don't follow you means I don't think what you're saying is rational. How does that grab you?
I still don't follow you.
Indeed, even our tests for sanity often assume that the line is present in nature and must be discovered or given visual existence.
Typography cracked, the voices of silence.
Take it easy, but take it.
What has been worked over to give it a general character, very, very few people can experience directly.
We are proud of our museums, where we display a way of living that we have made impossible.
The railway radically altered the personal outlooks and patterns of social interdependence. It bred and nurtured the American dream. It created totally new urban, social, and family worlds, new ways of work, new ways of management, new legislation. As the new electric technologies come into play, people are less and less convinced of the importance of self-expression. Teamwork succeeds private effort. Ours is the first age in which many thousands of the best trained minds have made it a full-time business to get inside the collective public mind. To get inside in order to manipulate, exploit, control.
The art of the speaker consists in compressing all of his aims into slogans.
We shape our tools, and thereafter, our tools shape us!
What'll happen when intelligence is recognized as a global resource?